because I'm representing staff, and Steve Bogos and Millie Patterson are also on the staff. The first scripture reading this morning is from Mark 9. And beginning with verse 30. They, meaning Jesus and the disciples, went on from there and passed through Galilee, and he would not have anyone know of it, for he was teaching his disciples, saying to them, "The Son of Man will be delivered into the hands of men, and they will kill him. And when he is killed, after 3 days, he will rise." But the disciples did not understand the saying, and they were afraid to ask him. And they came to Capernaum, and when he was in the house, he asked them, "What were you discussing along the way?" But they were silent, for on the way they had discussed with one another who was the greatest. And he sat down and called the 12, and he said to them, "If anyone would be first, he must be last of all and servant of all." And he took a child and put him in the midst of them, and taking him in his arms, he said to them, "Whoever receives one such child in my name receives me, and whoever receives me receives not me, but him who sent me."
And our second reading this morning is from James chapter 3, verses 13 through 18. Come now. Nope, I'm in the wrong chapter. Who is wise and understanding among you? By his good life, let him show his works in the meekness of wisdom. But if you have bitter jealousy and selfish ambition in your hearts, do not boast and be false to the truth. This wisdom is not such as comes down from above, but is earthly, unspiritual, devilish. For where jealousy and selfish ambition exist, there will be disorder and every vile practice. But the wisdom from above is first pure, then peaceable, gentle, open to reason, full of mercy and good fruits, without uncertainty or insincerity. And the harvest of righteousness is sown in peace by those who make peace. The word of the Lord.
Why? Well, the reason I go to church is because I want to learn more about God. learn together. And I like to work with other people to make church the best place it can be. How do you think you can make church a better place for you to learn about God?
Why are you asking me all the hard questions as a kid?
Yeah, but you seem pretty smart. And I'd like to know what you think.
Well, I guess we can keep talking about it. Maybe we'll figure it out. I don't know. What do you think?
Children's
what parts are the most fun? What parts are the least fun? Go ahead. Most fun?
The most fun is just relaxing.
Relaxing? So like being together, just hanging out?
Uh-huh.
Yeah. I think that's a really important part of church, right? Being together and hanging out? What do you think, Emma?
I think it's for me.
When we play together? Absolutely. Yeah. And we get to know each other. If we never hung out, I wouldn't even know you guys' names, right? And you might know my name, but you wouldn't know anything about me, right? So what, how about this? If you were going to start a church, what kind of person do you think should be in charge?
Well, me.
You should be in charge. You said someone who would study the aspects of church or what makes church work. Hi, Bella.
Hi.
And then do those things. Okay. All right. What are some of, this is a harder question, and I bet there's people out there actually that, I mean, I know they're all listening to us, but you can ignore them because they're just talking to you. But I wonder if they would even know the different aspects of church. So what do you think, what are all the different things that make church work? We have teams in our church that do all this stuff that makes it work, right? Can you think of any of them? Yeah, so there's people who comfort us, right? So the deacons take care of people when they're sick. We're trying to have a fire truck there. That's what's really important, which Daniel loves fire trucks. It's the first thing I learned about Daniel. Okay, so in order to be a church, right, what other groups are you in? Is anyone a Girl Scout or a Boy Scout or in other groups that you do? You're in Girl Scouts? And so what makes church different than Girl Scouts? Okay, here we learn about God, and in Girl Scouts we do fun activities. Anxious, right? Confused, and then we feel bad about ourselves because we don't understand. So, what helped your friends have?
Listening?
Yeah, that's a problem for everyone, you know? I know Jen and I
know about this. And if there's a laser coming up there, and you turn on the power, and it's up there, and then you're fine. That's just a way to make you ready to go to the top. No problem.
Yeah. that they know people other than their parents. Because they're starting out as church people, but the rest of you are going to teach them how to be a church person. And they're going to have to know your names in order to do it. So I encourage all of you to introduce yourself to them. Don't leave it to the kids to introduce them to you, okay? You guys are so helpful. Thank you so much. Can I say a prayer for our church? And then you can go to the next one. Yeah, let's pray.
Can I say something? If you pick a balloon out and put it out to the district and a flying thing in the air, you make up and hurt your head.
When you let the balloon go, hurt your head?
Yeah.
Before it flies into the air?
Is that a funny joke?
God, we're grateful for this church and for all the ways that you work in us. And so we ask particularly that you would help us to play more together. And we ask that you would help us to listen when it's hard to. And we thank you for all of the friendships that we have in this church that teach us how to know you better.